गुड मॉर्निंग, लेट अस मूव टू द नेक्स्ट आर्टिकल। Carnot's cycle. We shall study Carnot's cycles. At the same time, we shall talk about efficiency of Carnot's heat engine. Carnot's cycle is a reversible cycle. It is represented on a PV indicator diagram. This is PV indicator diagram. This is pressure P, volume V on Y axis, on X axis. So in this diagram I have shown Carnot's cycle. Carnot's cycle is a reversible cycle. It continues A, B, C, D. I am not going to find the work in terms of area. If you want, you can find the work in area also, in the form of area also. A, B, C, D, E, F, Z, H. Now let us start the working of Carnot engine in the form of Carnot cycle. What is happening at B? At B, we have the cylinder. In this cylinder, a working substance is filled it is taken as 1 gram mole. Working substance is filled in the cylinder and it is taken as 1 gram mole. The volume and pressure of this 1 gram mole at point A are P1 and V1. At A, the cylinder is placed on the source. At A, the cylinder is placed on the source. Bottom of cylinder is conducting, top of source is conducting. These two conducting portions, these two conducting surfaces are in contact. And therefore, what will happen? The working substance inside the piston receives heat energy from the source. Temperature of the source is always constant, it is T1. As heat energy is received by the working substance continuously, what will happen? There will be expansion of the working substance. Volume of the working substance will expand. At the same time, what will happen to the pressure? The pressure on the working substance will decrease. This is shown by the path A to B. What is happening from A to B? Here, the cylinder is placed on the source at constant temperature T1. Okay, so the working substance inside the source draws heat energy H1 from the source when it moves from A to B. When the source moves from the condition A to condition B, heat energy received by the working substance from the source is H1 at a constant temperature T1. This process is carried out at constant temperature T1. So, process AB is known as isothermal process. Process AB is known as isothermal process. In isothermal process, pressure changes, volume changes, heat energy changes, temperatures only remain constant. A to B is an isothermal process. In isothermal process, heat energy changes, volume changes, pressure changes, only temperature remains constant. And when we reach at B, we find that the isothermal process is completed at B. Isothermal process is completed at B. Here, pressure of the working substance is P2, volume is V2, temperature is T1. Let us see what is the work done on the working substance in the isothermal process from A to B. Let us call this work done is W1. It is done from A to B, and it is what? Isothermal process. A to B is isothermal process. Work done is W. Work done W1 from A to B during the isothermal process is integration from the lower volume V1 to higher volume V2. This is volume axis. Initial volume V1, final volume V2. V2 is more, V1 is less. Pressure P1, pressure P2. Earlier pressure P1 is large, now pressure P2 is small. PdV. Equation number 1. But we know that PV is equal to RT, and therefore let us write this P is equal to RT divided by V. Equation number 2. substitute equation 2 in equation 1 to get W1 is equal to integration within the limits V1 to V2 RT divided by V into DV. RT is constant, T1 is constant. Here afterward, this T will be T1. I am going to write this TI is T1. Okay. So, what is integration of 1 by V? It is natural logarithm of V. So, this is equal to RT1 natural logarithm of V. Limits are V1 to V2. This is for the RT1 into natural logarithm of V2 minus natural logarithm of V1. Use the quotient formula for logarithm. So log A minus log B will be log A divided by B. So this will be W is equal to RT1 into natural logarithm of V2 by V1, equation number 3. This is the work done on the working substance in the isothermal process from A to B, where pressure P decreased from P1 to P2, volume V increased from V1 to V2, temperature T1 is constant, amount of heat drawn from the source is H1. And therefore, let me write this work W1 somewhere here. W1 is equal to RT1 natural logarithm of V2 by V1. Okay, so we have completed AB part of the Carnot cycle. Now let us go for BC part. When we come at part B, when we come at point B, the cylinder is shifted from the source and now it is placed on the stand. At point B, the cylinder which is present on the source, which has already kept on the source, at B it is displaced from the source and kept on the stand. So at B, the cylinder having the working substance is placed on the stand, non-conducting stand. What is happening there? See, non-conducting stand does not receive any heat energy from the cylinder. All sides of cylinder are non-conducting, so heat energy is not lost by the cylinder. So what will happen? The pressure will start further decreasing from P2 to P3. Pressure decreases, and because of which the volume increases from V2 to V3. Here, heat energy is not allowed to gain or lost. There is no gain or loss of heat energy from B to C, and therefore the process from B to C is known as adiabatic process. Heat energy is not lost, heat energy is not gained. Without loss or gain of heat energy, the process takes place from B to C. Pressure decreases from P2 to P3, pressure axis वॉल्यूम इंक्रीज फ्रॉम वी टू टू वी थ्री, वॉल्यूम एक्सिस. ओके, नाउ व्हेन इट द प्रोसेस इज कंप्लीटेड फ्रॉम बी टू सी, आई टू सी, द टेम्परेचर हैज चेंज्ड. फ्रॉम बी टू सी देर इज नो चेंज इन टेम्परेचर, बट एट पॉइंट सी आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ द प्रोसेस इन बी सी, टेम्परेचर एट सी बिकम्स टी टू. प्रोसेस बी सी इज एडियाबेटिक प्रोसेस. इन एडियाबेटिक प्रोसेस देर इज नो चेंज इन हीट एनर्जी. टेम्परेचर हियर इज टी वन, टेम्परेचर हियर इज टी टू. टेम्परेचर हैज चेंज्ड फ्रॉम बी टू सी, दैट इज फ्रॉम टी वन टू टी टू, बिकॉज इट इज adiabatic process, it is not isothermal process. Let us find out the work done from B to C. Adiabatic process. Let us call this work as W2. This work is taking place from the point B to C. Work W1 AB in terms of area may be taken as area A, B, E, H. Work W1 may be taken as area A, B, E, H. That is what work W1. Now let us go for work W2 for the first adiabatic process. Adiabatic from B to C. Let us work out this. So W2 is equal to integration from V2 to V3 PdV equation number 4, but for adiabatic process PV to the power gamma is equal to constant K, and therefore P is equal to K divided by V to the power gamma, equation number 5. For adiabatic process P into V to the power gamma is constant K, and therefore from this equation P is this. Substitute equation 5 in equation 4 to get W2 is equal to integration within the limits V2 to V3, K is constant, is taken outside, 1 divided by V to the power gamma dV. This is K times V to the power minus gamma plus 1 divided by 1 minus gamma. The limits are V2 to V3. This is further KV3 to the power minus gamma plus 1 minus KV2 to the power minus gamma plus 1 whole divided by 1 minus gamma. But we know that for any adiabatic process P1 V1 to the power gamma is equal to P2 V2 to the power gamma is equal to P3 V3 to the power gamma is equal to constant K. So for this K, I can put P3 V3 to the power gamma. For this K, I can put P2 into V2 to the power gamma. And so W2 will further become P3 V3 to the power gamma into V3 to the power minus gamma plus 1 minus K V2 to the power 1 minus gamma. This is also 1 minus, sorry, I have to put value of K, that is P2 V2 to the power gamma into V2 to the power 1 minus gamma whole divided by 1 minus gamma. V3 base is same, V2 base is same, add the indices. V3 to the power gamma plus 1 minus gamma. Plus gamma minus gamma get cancelled. What left? V3. The same thing here. V2 base is same. Add the indices. Gamma plus 1 minus gamma. Plus gamma minus gamma will get cancelled. Or let me write it here. So it will be clear for you. P3 into V3 to the power gamma plus 1 minus gamma minus P2 into V2 power gamma plus 1 minus gamma divided by 1 minus gamma plus gamma minus gamma plus gamma minus gamma get cancelled. P3 V3 minus P2 V2, and this is simply what? P3 V3 minus P2 V2 divided by 1 minus gamma. According to PV is equal to RT, what will be P3 V3 will be, what is temperature for V3? T2. It will be T2 V3. For it, this it will be T1 V2. Okay. Using point C for P3 V3, point B for P2 V2, this may further be written as P3 V3 is RT2 minus RT1 divided by 1 minus gamma. RR can be taken common. If RR is taken common, it will be R into T2 minus T1 divided by 1 minus gamma. But we know that T2 is smaller than T1. So let us take minus sign common and send that minus sign to the denominator. So W2 will now become W2 is equal to R into T1 minus T2 divided by gamma minus 1, equation number 6. So this is the work done in the adiabatic process from B to C, and that will be B, C area, B, C, E, F. That will be area B, C, E, F. And so let me write it somewhere here. Area B, C, E, F is equal to work W2. And this is nothing but R into T1 minus T2, this whole divided by gamma minus 1. We shall remember this as work W2. I have written this for our reference, because when we go to find out total work done in this reversible cycle, we need those two equations. So from B to C, what work done is found here given by equation 6. After that, we have to go for C to D. At C, the cylinder is on the stand. Displace the cylinder from the stand and put the cylinder on the sink. Now, take the cylinder from the stand and put it on the sink. When the cylinder is put on the sink at C, the process will continue from C to D. This process is isothermal. This process is going to carry out at constant temperature T2. So this will be isothermal process and it will be a slow process. Adiabatic process is a fast process. Isothermal process is a slow process. And what is happening in this isothermal process from C to D? The pressure is increasing from P3 to P4. Volume is decreasing from V3 to V4. There is increase of pressure, decrease of volume. At the same time, heat energy H2 is rejected, is given to the sink at constant temperature T2. This thing will happen in this isothermal process from C to D. So let us find work done in the isothermal process from C to D. So work done W3 from C to D, which is isothermal process. Let us find this work done. So this is W3 and limits are V2 to V4, equation number 7. How much time is completed? Because I think this article may need more than 1 hour. So we shall have a break and continue the video for the remaining article so that it will be easy for you to download it and can watch the video. So let me break the video just for 1 second and we shall resume the thing so that second video will be automatically created.